One of the largest lakes in the world, the Caspian Sea plays an important role in the foundation of the unique climate in Turkmenistan. It's rich in biodiversity. The Caspian takes the attention of many forests, monuments, amazing natural features, including mud volcanoes. One of the peculiar features of the Caspian Coast is the mud volcano. The volcano is a geological formation that appears above channels and cracks in the Earth's crust, through which lava, ash, hot gases, vapors, water, and rock fragments erupt into the Earth's surface. This is the most powerful, amazing, and at the same time one of the most dangerous natural phenomena. Volcanoes are a phenomenon that fundamentally changes the original shell of the Earth and contributes to the formation of existing landscape. Volcanoes to this day continue to polish the Earth's shell. According to available information, there are 1,500 awakened volcanoes on the globe, which at times makes themselves felt. During active action, volcanoes spew energy thousands of times stronger than the most powerful nuclear bomb. However, over time, these volcanoes cease to operate. Instead of them, to this day, mud volcanoes operate. A number of volcanoes are built in Turkmenistan stage from the village of Ithimli upwards towards the north, not reaching the mountains of the small Balkans from Boyada, located in the southwest towards Balkan Alatmolara, towards the village of Khadar, towards the Apsharon Peninsula. There are more than 40 volcanoes in the number of volcanoes in Turkmenistan. It was revealed that strong changes have taken place on the Akpatlu volcano. You can say that Akpatlu is the largest among the volcanoes of this series and attracts the attention of all travelers whose path is nearby. A small volcano on the first hill of Akpatlu was sometimes active. Mud streams flowing to the lowland on the south side will fill this lowland, indicates. During the cessation of the flow of mud lava, the edges of this crater hardened, and gradually the edges of the volcanic crater rose layer by layer. The two lava flows that appeared on a small hill on the side of the former volcano were more powerful than the previous one. Despite the fact that the width of the crater has not increased much in size, its smooth surface filled with lava has changed its relief. Numerous small and large volcanoes testify that at present the power of the volcano is increased, despite the fact that the crater of the volcano reaches 150 meters. Lava flows out in some place near it. In one part of this crater, there is sudden outburst, and in another, one of the bubbles constantly extends. Features of the hills located near the large volcano Akpatlu indicate that the location and composition of nearby volcanoes is constantly changing. Thank you. The approach was to build up of a state, protection of nature of our country, and rational use of natural resources is one of the main directions of the state policy in order to protect and conduct scientific research on the flora and fauna of our nature resources working in our homelands. According to their natural conditions, those resources differ from each other by their biodiversity. One of those resources varying with this peculiarity of flora and fauna in the Khadar State Nature Reserve located at the southeast shores of the Khadar Sea. One of the unique places of the Khadar State Nature Reserve is the Old Jolly State Nature Reserve located on the island of the same name. The first reason for creating a state natural reserve is to reduce the impact of human activity on the birds that exist here. The second reason is related to the maintenance of gazelles that are considered there here mainly is about with their breeding and further relocation of the semi-woodland gazelles. In some places there are sandy hummocks and the coast is littered with shells. The water expanse of the island Old Jolly is rich for the algae and small animals, various types of fish and birds, and these factors attract the attention of everyone. All kinds of fish that live in the Caspian Sea can be found in the water shallow of the island. One of the unique places of the Khadar State Nature Reserve is the Old Jolly State Nature Reserve located in the island of the same name. The first reason for creating a state nature reserve is to reduce the impact of human activity on the birds that exist here. The second reason is related to the maintenance of gazelles that are considered right here. Mainly it's about with their breeding and further location of semi-freedom gazelles. The island is lying from north to south and it takes 9,000 hectares. The 7,000 hectares of island is attached to a special reserve. The nature of the island is so poor, its cool and chilly weather effectively influence the growing of plants. There are critical opportunities that will possibly affect to the growing and living conditions of gazelles and their kids because there exists none of the predators that could be an obstacle in their growing and reproduction processes. Despite the desert hills of the island, most of the lands are densely covered by plants and 65 kinds of vascular plants can be met here. This island deeply impressed scientists and tourists by its flora and fauna. The calmness of the Caspian Sea small waves of the surface was a sacred music. White waves was amazing, the white waves with small bubbles of the surface takes to the world of thoughts. Of the largest mud volcano located in the southwest of Turkmenistan, this wonderful mud volcano which rises gradually up and its cone-like amount reaches 1.5 kilometers, its height makes up 70 meters. This mud volcano is located 70 kilometers north of the mud volcano Kaina Depen, 8 kilometers from the shore of the Caspian Sea. This mud volcano looks more wonderful from the side of Ekerem. According to the existing data, the hollow of the mud volcano either looks like a hole, which unfilled with water, or mud volcano filled with lava up to its brim. At first, it seems to have been created from the lava pouring from one place. However, according to the research held here, it has been established that this mud volcano is not one, but two, and they have changed their places for the two times. It has been also established that there are sealed layers under the mud volcanoes. The first source of Gökpatlı mud volcano near its present crater is believed to have appeared several million years ago. Scholars have called theirs crater Ekerem. According to scholars, the mud erupted from this mud volcano comes from the more great depth than that of the oil and gas. Therefore, scholars think that here may be rich oil and gas reserves undiscovered near. Gökpatlaud creates a great interest of people. One could reach its throat from any side and ascend its top through a small slope. It amazes any person who comes close to it with its difference from the mud volcano. It has a blue strip on its top, and one can realize that why it's called Gökpatlaud. Soft soil of the locality and shape of erupted lava attracted the attention of any person. Here one feels that he moves on a soft quilt and feels careful as one feels very softness under one's foot. The slope coming downwards and it runs through the shallow ravines and reaches the top of the Gökpatlaud and is visible some mud lavas at the bottom of ravines. There have been great changes in these mud volcanoes. In fact, that one can see that its activity has increased remarkable and its craters filled with mud. The movement of mud coming out from the course of crater is wonderful. Standing on the top of the mound, one can see here all changes clearly. Ranges in a zigzag shape coming downwards, dunes of soil mounds remind you wonderful landscape. Difference of colors of erupted muds also speaks of their history. Therefore, it's not difficult to say something of their action, movement, and amount of mud without exploration. Here, wide and small ranges of soil mounds amaze visitors. At the bottom of these ravines, one can see frozen mud courses, and some of these mud courses disappear in the caves. Wonderful slopes of Gökpatlaud, as well as the unusual soft soil of the locality, makes you feel as if you are another planet. The crater was raised with mud flows frozen around its mouth. In the middle of the crater, mud boil regular bubbles, and they are getting wider. Black bubbles on the surface of the mud volcano also speak of the fact that there may be reserves of crude oil and natural gas under the mud volcano. In the prosperous epoch of the powerful stay, all the necessary conditions for a good race and travel to the beautiful mountain landscapes located in various parts of our country are created for the Turkmen citizens. Under the leadership of the same president, great attention is paid not only to the development of all sectors of our state, but also to the careful preservation of the nature around us. A striking example of this is the work carried out by the workers of the Hünyadağ State Reserve, the mountains area of the mountain top of the Balkan Wilayet. These are the Ay Mountains, located in the southwest of Turkmenistan, in one of the most beautiful places of the Kapadar, near the village of Matumlay, in the Thumburg Gorge. When you first come to this land, you feel as if you are in places where no human has ever set foot. The local population calls these hills the Mountains of the Moon. Small tops of different shades are striking their uniqueness of the surface of which nothing grows. Admiring In the beautiful view of the moonlight mountains, enjoying the clean mountain air, you feel yourself in a fantastic fairy world. The area of the moon mountains looks like a small plain, onto which is a way were poured from different volumes of basalt hills of sand. The grayish blue soil of the moon mountains resembles salmon in color. According to scientists, different shades of dyes can be obtained from the hills of the lunar mountains of different colors. The soil of the lunar mountains contains both small pebbles and just earth. The history of the origin of these stones is associated with certain geophysical phenomena. Pebbles which crumble under strong pressure make up most of the composition of the soil of the lunar mountains. Between the blue hills you can see a stretch of sand gathering little by little. It's a soil belt formed as a result of the destruction of stones and wind blow sand. Only here can you find any kind of vegetation, including wormwood. On thicker layers of fertile soil, other types of plants grow which are resistant to harsh soil and climate conditions. On thicker layers of fertile soil, other types of plants grow which are resistant to harsh soil and climate conditions. Another feature of the Moon Mountains is that the water of almost all springs here have medicinal properties. Tourists are imaged here by a lake that suddenly opens up to their gaze, which is hundreds of meters in width and length. The slight excitement of a mountain lake in the winds, the relief of the moon mountains, the color of the peaks and the location of the hills, the bizarre glare of the sun rays refracting on the shiny as if covered with cloud slopes, all this creates the impression that you are another planet. The lake formed as a result of natural phenomena further adorns the landscape of the moon mountains. Despite the fact that this lake has salty sulfur water, there is almost no vegetation around. Birds flock to its surface in search of shelter, since it's very rare to find animals here that would come here to quench their thirst. The warm sulfuric water of the lake is an excellent remedy for many ailments. Springs and streams on the territory of the Moon Mountains are one of the most favorite places for travelers. As the famous Turkmen poet Kerim Gurbani Pesov wrote, the mountains that have seen Farahi attract travelers with their amazing beauty to this day. The wiggling colored clays of various thickness show us the result of the centuries of labor of a wonderful artist called nature.